Organizational data types are now available in preview in Excel. So I can now do things like this. Put some staff names in here, go to my staff demo data type in Excel, and then I can extract data about those people, as long as that data is in my table. So I can pull out where they've lived, what their LinkedIn URL is, and even which office they're based in. Okay, so how do we do this? I'll show you now. Let's go. So the process has to begin in Power BI Desktop. Now, before I get into this, two clear points to be made. You must have an E5 Microsoft 365 subscription, which is the most expensive subscription there is. Okay, it's the top of the range, and not many people have that. You also have to have Power BI and a Power BI Pro license, which again is a paid subscription. So this whole solution is for quite a niche audience. So I'm just stating that right at the beginning so you're not disappointed afterwards, okay? You don't find it. It's a preview feature in Power BI. So you have to turn that on by going to File, Options, Preview, okay? Preview features, and turn on Featured Tables. Let me just show you that very quickly. Also, you need to have the beta channel, which is the real early release of Excel as of now, but it'll slowly be rolled out. But again, as I say, you just won't have this functionality unless you have the most expensive subscription to Office, the E5 license, Enterprise. So under preview features, your featured tables is ticked, so we're okay. And I've got some data that I've pulled in, so staff name, where they've lived, office, image URL, qualifications, things like this. All the stuff I want to show up in my data type in Excel. Now the key thing is this, you have to go to the model view, you click on the table, and down here it says is featured table. You say yes, and a little box will pop up in 1 second. So here's the demo. The row label, you just pick. In my example, I had Wynn and Jeff, so it's the names. That was the names that are going to trigger the data type, if you like. And then the other thing is this key column. So you need a column with unique values. Now, I've put two people called Tess into my table, so it hasn't got unique values in it. So what I'm going to do is actually add an index column using Power Query. So I'll do that really quickly. So now I've done that, I can now turn my feature table on and then pick this index column and save. Next step, I have to publish this report to the Power BI workspace, and then there's one more step. So I've published the report to the workspace. Here's the data set. Now, for this to show up for me in my Excel, I have to have an admin setting turned on. So you go to Settings, Admin Portal, and then within that admin portal, it's under Tenant Settings. And then if you scroll down, there is Featured Content. Okay, it's not that. It's the next one underneath it. Allow connection to featured tables. So you click on that and you can enable it, the entire organization or specific security groups, and you can set it that way. Okay, there is one more thing you can do. There is an organizational button, and I'll show you that shortly on the Excel side. If you want data to be found when somebody clicks the organization button rather than a specific data set, you have to certify that data set. So back in my workspace, I actually have to go to the data set and go to settings. So under settings, there's an endorsement option. And again, that feature of endorsement needs to be turned on by the admin. And if you certify a data set, then it'll be included. That featured table will be included in Excel search when you click on the organization button. And I'll show you that in a second. A couple of final comments and notes. This organization button only scans through your certified data sets. So not only does the table have to be a featured table, it also then has to be marked as certified. Because if I click on this organization button on TESS, you'll notice that nothing really happens, and you'll get this little pop-out box at the side saying no results found. However, if I go to the specific table where I know TESS exists, i.e. the staff demo table, I click on that and it will find her. Also, there's two TESSes in my data. So therefore I get this data selector box pops out, and I can pick Test Ted from the USA or Test Ting from the UK. So I'll go the USA TESS, and then I can say, okay, what office? New York. So just be aware, these tables are specific. The organization one scans through all your featured tables that are also certified. Finally, you can do all other sorts of good Excel stuff with this. So if I have my data types and I drop in the image URL, and then with a simple bit of VBA code, I click this button and it'll run away, go grab the images, drop them in the cells, and there we have it. So you can do all sorts with this stuff. Look, it is E5 only, the most expensive license. You have to have a Power BI license in order to publish and connect to these data sets. So it's a real niche audience that this is going to be for. But I thought I'd show you. It's hot off the press. It's just been released. And hopefully you found this insightful and you may have some uses for it. Let me know what you think. Thanks for watching. Catch you next time.